you how to make the ray, the stingray. Here it is. This is the two-toned version with the underbelly and the tail being white. The monochromatic version is as so. For the sake of clarity, video. Make sure I'm focused here. Take clarity. I'm going to do the two-tone version. So, we'll start. Fully in half. Corner to corner. The same, perpendicular. Focus up. So, from there, fold in half. So, now here's where you make the decision whether or not you want it to be two-toned or one color. So, if you want it to be two-toned like we're going to do, you put your colored side up, you take this corner, and you fold it up to the middle. Along this crease, bring the corner to the center. If you wanted to do it monochromatically, you can just do that just as easily. You can do that by flipping it the other way, like this. I suppose if you wanted, you could do it half and half if you'd like. That'll be neat. I have to try that here soon. So next, this is the tricky part. Going to fold, first reinforce these creases here diagonally, and then this one right here, then fold, then collapse it like so. So here will be the wings or fins, what have you. This will start to become the body and the tail. So, I'm going to fold this in, like so. This will be your, just like in the traditional crane. These in. It's a little weird because of its extra layer on it, but if you just be firm with it, it'll go right just fine. There we go, get that point nice and pointy. There we go. And fold it up. Next, for overuse and pre-priesting on the wing. So we'll start by folding along this line right here. Like so. Oh, and I did forget a crease here that I should have done right before that. Fold this across, get a center line. We need that center line because we're going to take this line and fold it along the center line. Line it up like so. There's a tendency to tear up here later on, so if you want to leave a little extra space, don't fold right up to the point. It's probably beneficial. And then you're going to do the same thing on the other side. Center line, like so. There we go. Now, we're going to leave that alone. We're going to fold these together and fold that up. Alright. We're going to take this line, go to this edge, fold it to this edge. So, we do the same thing on the other side. And we'll flip it back around and do more on this side. So the same thing on the other side. There we go. And straight forward. So now, we have this crease here from folding earlier. We're going to use that crease now. We're going to fold this line up. This edge to this edge again, just like on the other side. Then we're going to tuck it underneath this crease that I pointed out before. There we go, like so. Do the same thing on the other side. Almost there. What we're going to do next is we're going to go back to these creases on top. So we're going to open this up and open these up. Now we're going to fold this across. Fold this across. And fold on this first crease here, opposite of what originally was folded. And then we're going to tuck that other crease right underneath, like so. And the same thing here. There we go. So now, we look inside here.
We have this pocket.
I'm going to take this corner and put it into that pocket. Do the same thing on the other side. Find the pocket and put it in. There we go. Oop. So that one slipped out. It's a little bit tricky because it doesn't hold together well until you do the shaping on the tail. The shaping is actually entirely necessary to hold this whole thing together. It holds pretty well once you shape it, but initially it's going to be a bit of a bear. So then I like to tuck this center bit in a little bit, pinch it, get in there and start twisting it around, do a little extra curl with the tail if you'd like. Maybe keep it in one direction, maybe like turning or something, you know, like so. And then it holds together fairly well. There we are. Then, give your wings some curl, upwards, downwards, however you want, this is all up to you. Bob Ross would say, this is your ray. You do with it what you want. Give it a twist on it just because it holds a little bit better when you do it that way. Just a little compound bit. And there you have it, your completed ray.